This type of a car bomb, which happened on the CRP convoy on 14th, as you are all aware, it happened after a long time in Kashmir, and with this type of intensity, it had not happened earlier. However, similar incidents have happened in the other countries, in Syria, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan earlier. And since this modus operandi now has been started by the terrorists, we are alive to it, we are keeping our tracks open, and we are keeping all options open to deal with this type of modus operandi in future.
Why did the was Kamran mastermind of the suicide attack on CRPF? Number two, Mr. Zulfikar has an IGP CRPF talked about the stress Kashmiris are facing outside the country. Army has this Sadbhavna program for last more than 2 decades to win hearts and minds of the people. Whatever is happening because of the in the wake of this attack on Kashmiris, is that a setback to your strategy to win back hearts and minds?
First of all, the question about Kamran. Gentlemen, Kamran was Chief Operations Commander of Jaish-e-Mohammed in Kashmir. He was a Pakistani and he was being handled by the Jaish-e-Mohammed of Pakistan in conjunction with ISI and Pakistan Army from across the border. So he was the top commander of the Jaish-e-Mohammed which carried out the 14th February convoy attack. So we have eliminated the top commander of the Jaish-e-Mohammed which carried out the attack. Now whether who was involved, what was the role of each and every other player in that attack on the convoy, as I told earlier, is a matter of investigation. I would not like to share the operational details of that incident. Now coming to the second point about the Kashmiri youth and the Sadbhavna. Sadbhavna is a very well thought out, well planned out way we are going about healing, giving a healing touch to the Kashmiri youth, the Kashmiri far-flung areas. That will continue, and we every time renew it, we review it, and we try and make it more effective, and we will continue to do that.
So my point was about what is happening to Kashmiris in other parts of
the
country. The
question about Kashmiris in other parts of the country, gentlemen, it's a political and an administrative question outside the purview of my domain. So I would not like to comment on that. Administration has commented on that, and there is a very positive outcome of that which is now being seen.
Neeraj.
पाकिस्तान आर्मी जैश ए मोहम्मद पाकिस्तान आर्मी का ही एक बच्चा है. जैश ए मोहम्मद को पाकिस्तान आर्मी ही कंट्रोल कर रही है और ऐसा ही कंट्रोल कर रही है. और जैसे कि आपने कल जैश ए मोहम्मद का रिलीज भी देखा होगा, उन्होंने ये कबूला भी है कि उनका चीफ ऑपरेशंस कमांडर जो है इस हमले में मारा गया है. तो पाकिस्तान आर्मी का इन्वॉल्वमेंट इसमें 100% है, इसमें मेरे को और आपको किसी को कोई शक नहीं.
सर, पास्ट एक डेढ़ साल में जो फोर्सेस का कंसंट्रेशन था वो लश्कर और हिज्ब पे था, क्या इसका फायदा उठाकर जैश ने अपना नेटवर्क बना लिया है और आज की डेट में कितने जैश के लड़के होंगे जो साउथ कश्मीर और नॉर्थ कश्मीर में ऑपरेट कर रहे हैं?
पॉइंट इज दैट जो आपने बताया जैश ए मोहम्मद के ऊपर पूरी फोकस सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस की रही है. पिछले साल 58 जैश के जो कार्डर्स थे वो मारे गए हैं. इस बार अभी 31 एलिमिनेशन हुआ है, तो 31 एलिमिनेशन में 12 जैश मोहम्मद के लोग मारे गए. तो ऐसी कोई बात नहीं कि जैश मोहम्मद के ऊपर फोकस नहीं है, पूरी तरह से फोकस है. एंड ऑल्सो यू हैव टू अप्रिशिएट 2018 देर वॉज नॉट अ सिंगल अटैक, सुसाइडल अटैक और दैट नेचर ऑफ अटैक विथ जैश कुड कैरी ऑन. So we are working on it and we are trying our best. There are credible leaks also, as it was said, and we are after them.
So talking of Ghazi, talking of Ghazi, from the last couple of days we've seen a lot of theories about him, that he's an Afghan war veteran. So many things, I mean, so many inputs about him. Also the fact that since Afghanistan, we've seen US withdrawal from Afghanistan, and talking of the larger picture, there could be a case where those people may be directed towards the Kashmir Valley, and this is seen as a kind of a curtain raising to this Ghazi. So how do you see that overall picture as far as American withdrawal to the general sir?
First of all, talking about the so-called Ghazi, you know it better than me in Kashmir, kitne Ghazi aaye, kitne chale gaye. So there's nothing new in it. All these aliases keep happening, and we'll handle them. There's no problem about it. Let any Ghazi come. Now, talking about the situation in Afghanistan and its impact on Kashmir, I think a lot has been written on it, a lot has been said about it. Coming down to the Kashmir Valley, we are very clear, anyone who enters Kashmir Valley will not go back alive in whichever way. So our focus is very clear on counter-terrorism operations.
Sir, on the backdrop of this attack which happened in our people, there were clear intelligence inputs also that militants have infiltrated, especially Jaish-e-Mohammed squads who are planning to carry out strike around 9 and 11 Do we have still some dying militants present in the Srinagar or Kashmir Valley who are planning to carry out such attacks? Number one. Number two question is, sir, during last 2 years, you have eliminated a lot of militants, including local and foreign militants. But there was a trend that recruitment was going on alongside with the involved militants. What is the status of recruitment right now? Did forces succeeded in curtail that recruitment of militants to some extent?
The first part of the question, the intelligence inputs about such attacks or similar attacks. I mean, there are a lot of intelligence inputs about various types of modus operandi of the terrorist, which I would not like to share in this press conference because that's operational information in nature. But suffice it to say, I would like to assure everyone that all types of intelligence inputs, as I said, the team security forces here, we are taking into account all intelligence inputs and we are acting on it. What happens is only probably about 1 or 2% of what has been denied to them. The actions of security forces based on intelligence, there are a lot of actions by the terrorists which are not allowed to happen. So naturally it doesn't come into the open domain. Now second point about recruitment. Yes, definitely the recruitment has come down in the recent months and that's a good sign. I would like to compliment the awam of the Kashmir for this and the youth that recruitment has come down. Because as I said earlier, you pick up a gun, you are dead, unless you surrender. I would also like IGP Kashmir to say on the recruitment if he has something to say.
Recruitment, it was mentioned by the Corps Commander, there is a significant dip in the recruitment, which you all know. The statistics are a reflection of that. So we don't see recruitment in last 3 months. The recruitment has significantly come down. And we would request the families, there are families who are paying key role. We know, I would not like to name the individuals here because of their personal security and protection. There are families who actually made a lot of effort to bring their sons back and that helped. So we would also like urge through this platform that the families have a very important role to play. The community has a very important role to play to curtail recruitment. And that is what we are seeing. There was a fear, element of fear in some villages, some places, we see an element of fear. Where a boy, there is an encounter which is taking place in the house, then there is also, we have seen the force to join, and that kind of evidence has also come in some cases. So what we would request, with the top commanders getting eliminated, the vintage element going out, the terror scenario, the security scenario has actually improved and the terror elements have been crushed. We are giving a very strong investigational measure. We are trying to, the collaborators, those people who are actually co-conspirators in generating this kind of action, this kind of terror incident, we are acting very tough on them. So I'm sure with all this thing, recruitment has seen a visible dip and it will gradually go down.
Gaurav Sawant.
Sir, my name is Gaurav Sawant. I work for India Today. I have two questions, one for the police and the other for the army. Sir, as far as recruitment is concerned, you addressed that, but what was the explosive that was used? How did that explosive come into India? Where was it fabricated? That's investigation part. And radicalization of local boys, is that a major issue for the army or for the security forces, and how are you dealing with that?
The question about the type of explosive which was used in the investigation, the incident, we have the leads, we have the details, but I would not like to share it here today because the investigation is still going on. Now, second point about the radicalization, as you are all aware, yes, the inimical elements are involved in ever radicalization of the youth of Kashmir, but notwithstanding, the efforts of the security forces, the efforts of the government, the administration and the think tank and the opinion makers in the society, it has helped in reducing that methods of radicalization in the recent past, and I will say it is work in progress. And we will continue to put our efforts and attempts towards that effort in a very collective manner. And towards the radicalization, that's a major issue. and the work in progress is there as of now.
Thank you.